Hey folks, it's a Sunday. I just wanted to show something that was kind of interesting that I just noticed. And by the way, this right here, these are micro swords. And that's what you're seeing there. And then this is dwarf hair grass. And my guess is that big tall stuff in the back isn't dwarf. Based on, it's like the tallest I've ever seen in my life, but if it is dwarf, but anyway, in the micro swords, I'm not going to butcher the language, but this is what it is. I can't say that word, but you can see it all bunched up, and then I just kind of split it up and pulled it around, and the trick is just to get it to root. Once it gets through that layer of sand into the fluoride and then starts rooting, it starts doing really well. But I just noticed something, and this is the bottom of the banana plant. You can see, if you remember, the lilies were going yellow, and posted how I was going to cut and trim. You can see all the places I cut and trim. Then you can see a runner coming up. See how this is yellow? And then look at this. Here's the other one. These are two banana plants, by the way, but see how that's yellow? See how it's going up, and it's got the lily kind of, the, you know, where the lily pad's going to sprout on it. And there's another one. If you follow this and we'll follow it on up, keep going. Then right here you can see it's getting ready to curl out to a lily pad. And then you can actually see these lily pads here at the top. And then, you know, if you follow one down, we'll follow it down to the, and give you an idea. This is what we're looking at. Okay. But one thing I wanted to point out, I always wondered how this thing propagates. Some things have runners, but notice that this, see how green that is? See the leaf on it? Now watch this. They're going horizontal. Look at the dark green. See how dark green that is? It's not a light green. See that one? Light green. Dark green. Greenish brown. Look what it's doing. Looks like it's bending down. See? Looks like it's going to stick there, and then that's going to come roots, and then that's going to be a baby banana plant. Same here. See how it's running horizontal? It's not running for the light. It's wanting to go horizontal to the dirt, run out, and then root and dig down. I think these are runners for the banana plant. You know, I don't know. I've never had a banana plant do what this one's doing. I just thought that was pretty cool. Thought that was worth sharing. And one other thing. Look at that rubber lip. He likes to hang out under that log, which is the funniest thing. He likes to own that place. And he likes the new life spectrum pellets. When they fall down to the ground, he'll come out and start sucking them up. But anyway, which, I don't know. I guess I thought he was just purely a vegetarian, but he likes new life spectrum pellets. So he's definitely likes the taste of that. But one thing I wanted to show you guys, see this? These are the new leaves on the lace plant. See those two? See how weird it looks. It looks really, I can't get much closer. You can kind of see the ridging on it to show you that, you know, but notice there's a full grown one, and then these are shoots for new leaves. This, give you an idea, this green one, notice how it's a light green, the one here in the middle that I have in the frame. I'm going to put it in the middle of the frame. It's in the middle of the frame. That one is all the way at the top now. Okay, this is 2 feet deep. It's coming from here. Well, and plus the substrate, but I don't know. It's a good 20 inches tall. But these, you can compare it to these older leaves. See how they're kind of darker green? And then this is a brighter green. But the point I'm getting at is it's Sunday, and you have these two little runners here for new leaves. Those leaves shoot at such a rate, it's unbelievable. By this time next week, they will be in this kind of configuration, and that's in 7 days. So mark this word, it's Sunday, and I'm predicting, well, all right, maybe 2 weeks, but I'm betting like seven to 10 days, and the angelfish has to get in the way. I'm betting 7 to 10 days, those two leaves right there are going to be like the full grown, and that's just the neatest plant. And notice you can see the water rippling right there, and you can see it moving in the wisteria. I've got really good flow rate. So I've got, the lighting's a lot higher than I thought they liked it. It's under 4 T5HO bulbs, but it just seems to be doing really well. And There's the whiptail catfish, and I if you guys remembered, I talked about, you can see the end of the tail. It's almost like that's a mechanism so that if somebody's looking for a worm or something, they hit that, and my guess is that breaks off. That's just the weirdest. And he looks like he's kind of an algae eater, but he looks for the new life spectrum pellets as well. And what's really funny is that rubber lip, the rubber lip really claims this turf, and I'll bet you money that if he gets near the rubber lip, the rubber lip's going to chase him off. We'll just see. Let's just sit and watch. But that is a whiptail catfish. And very interesting markings, and he's going to get near the rubber lip. He's kind of backing up. Yeah, he's not going over there. If there were food, the rubber lip would go after him. So, but that's what he's doing. He's actually looking for food on the bottom. And I fed him a little while ago. And so he's hoping to find a fed him bloodworms. I think he's hoping to find a bloodworm. Active little guy. Interesting little feeder. Just kind of crawls around. I cannot believe the rubber lip is just sitting there. And he saw the rubber lip, and he's like, I'm out of here. But that's definitely an interesting form of a catfish. And then you can see the barbs on the quarry cat. He's just kind of sitting there. And he's going to swim around and look for stuff. And then one other thing I wanted to show you guys. Look at the, see the glass cats hanging out? They're just like hanging out. It's kind of a neat picture. And everything's doing well. There's a, speaking of catfish, I've got a, they're in the corner on the glass. You can see it, it's a twig catfish. And I can't see the genus phylum. And then look at this one here. I've got two in the tank. You can see it on the piece of driftwood back there. The blue ram will get out of the way. But they're just a really neat fish. The twig catfish, if you see the nose, see how it's kind of like the Pinocchio nose? The difference between the male and the female is the male will actually get bristles on it. So as they're almost full grown now, but as they get adult, the male back there, he'll get little bristles on it. I don't know what to call it. I mean, it just looks like bristles. I don't know. I guess it's similar to a mustache or facial hair. Beats me. But it will, if it's a male, it'll get that. And if it's a female, it'll be smooth. And that's how you tell the difference between them. And anyway, really neat fish. I don't know if it's a he or a she. There's another one here in the corner. And, two really neat catfish. There's the crips that I planted a few days ago. They're doing well. I don't really see any melting. And you can see there's some micro swords in there, and I got a little bit of algae on them. And hair grass, and then the dwarf hair grass right here. Micro swords, and you can see algae on that. I have no idea what this plant is, and it's one of those plants that just looks hideous. And I don't know what's going on. The bottom one there looks green, looks like it's getting light. And then this thing you can see where it's melted some, you know, all these leaves have come off, and it's just kind of a stem. And there's another version of this one, and it's back here. And I don't know if it's gonna make it or not. We'll see. The lilly is looking like it's gonna make it, and that's a runner off of the oriental sword. That is a runner, and then that was a runner, and I'm just kind of letting them get bigger. I'm planning on just taking them to the, it's gonna outgrow the spot, the one on the left, and this one right here on the right is gonna outgrow that spot. But what I plan on doing is just taking it to the pet store when it gets really big and getting credit for something, who knows what. But the dwarf baby tier is doing awesome. You can see the roots. You can see how it really is starting to carpet, and it's really starting to run, the runners on it. And it's in a really good spot. I got kind of lucky, I guess, putting it here in this corner. And the reason is, if you notice the water here, the current, there's a downdraft right here as it hits this return, and it pushes debris and food and whatever into this little area, and then it really, you can kind of see some junk right in there, but it just helps give this food, you know. That's what plants like. They, you know, in the wild, they just live off of debris and detritus, or whatever you want to call that stuff, fish poop. But another interesting little tidbit is I get this white. If you see the white in the sand, those are actually snails. And what happens is I get snails down in my FX5. And then if they ever die in the FX5, they end up just getting discharged out that nozzle. And it's kind of blown out and fall down. It's kind of like a snail shell graveyard. I have no idea why, but that's kind of what's going on. That's the only place in the tank where the little white shells tend to collect, and I need to try to pick them up. There's some Anubias right here, two little pieces of Anubias. They're on the left side of here. I'm going to put them in the center frame. And here's another really cool piece of Anubias. I'm just trying to let it grow out. You can see all the runners on it and anchor. And then I got another little neat piece of Anubias. And it's really doing a neat job of anchoring on that plant right there. Just a great plant. The angelfish will get out of the way. I don't know that they're going to, but whatever. Let's see if I can get around them. But yeah, right there, you can see how it's just doing well. And here's a better shot of the twig catfish. See it going up the glass? That is a great fish for a planted tank if you have driftwood. They really like to chew on driftwood. And as you can see, this guy here is kind of just hanging out. And they get about 7 inches, so they're just an odd looking fish. Twig catfish, great one. And then I'm just going to pull back. And one other thing, I'll show you the dwarf baby tear here from the side. There's the dwarf baby tear. You can see it. See how well it, see it's starting to run. So it's building up against the glass, and then it's starting to run on out. And I'm going to let it fill this whole corner. That would just be ideal. And then my hope is that this lily right here will fill this other area. And then the lily, it'll have such big leaves on it that it will keep the light from hitting here, and it will be a natural deterrent for the dwarf baby tear. The dwarf baby tear won't crawl into the shadow. It'll stay in. It needs high light. But you can see the that's the wisteria, and I just kind of push it up in the corner there. It does really good. Wisteria is great. Matter of fact, I got a snail. I have a lot of snails in here, but I got one right there. But it does. Wisteria is great near a high water flow area, and you can see how much water's coming off the FX5. And I've got an open nozzle now, so anyway, but the plants are back here. I'm going to try something really odd. We'll see if this works. But I'm going to see if I can slide this. Whoops, got in the way of the camera. We'll see if I can slide this. First, I'm going to do is I'm going to just kind of step back, stand here for a little bit, and let you see the whole tank. Just like this. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to try to walk the camera behind the glass. I don't have any backdrop behind my tank. That's just it's just the wall. But I'm going to see if I can't. I'm going to stay here for like 2 minutes, and then I'm going to see if I can't run this behind the tank so that you guys can see it from a different angle. And me as well, I can't get back there. There's just not much room. And I have no idea what it's going to look like. I'm going to see if I can do a good job of fishing it back there. I want to stay here just a few more. I'll stay here for about 15 seconds. At the 15-minute mark, I'm going to work my way behind the tank. All right, here we go. Start moving. Oh, and one other thing. I've had people ask me about this guy. And it's... That's actually a black skirt tetra. But it's got, you know, the long fin. And to me, that's just a... kind of a frizzy hair kind of thing. But definitely pretty. I think it's a she. She likes to show off and let her hair. Pretty. This one has the wildest tail. If you notice, it's got that black skirt right there. You see, it's kind of just a weird design in the... There you go, see it? Isn't that weird? Just a wild pattern, almost like a diamond there. But anyway. One other thing I've been doing, and I was at the pet store the other day, or the fish store, local fish store, and I looked at this. I've been wanting to do CO2, and this guy was telling me they got some in. And I do this. I do two caps, if I remember, once a day or like once every other day. And this is a carbon substitute. And I think this has been helping me. I've been using this actually to try to help prevent algae. Because somebody said that, you can see here, what it does is it helps the plants grow quicker. And if your plants grow really quick, the algae doesn't have time to hang out on them. And I don't fully understand that, but that's what everybody says. Here's a great shot of the twig catfish. There's that one. And I can't tell by looking at the nose. You can see the nose. But as they get older, if that was a male, it had bristles on it. And it does a great job of cleaning. And I'll let you watch that. That is a neat fish. And I've got another one. He's just hanging out. He or she. They really like to hang out on the wood. And in low light and low visibility water conditions, I don't know how you'd ever see that thing. And it's funny, one time I was taking the tank apart, and I had one actually get on the planter stick. I didn't have any plants in there at all, and it got actually on the planter stick. It was just kind of funny. But give you an idea, that's the smaller one. Just interesting fish. Great cleaner. So for a sucker lip, very, very, very neat fish. But very peculiar. I had one of these back in the 80s, and I named it Spock because it just looked, I don't know, it just kind of had the pointed ears kind of look. It would get on the glass, and I don't know, I can't describe it, but Spock seemed to fit. All right, here we go. We're going to go behind the glass and making this the longest video ever. See how I do. The trick with this iPad is to put it back there and then not. All right, here we go. All right. Here's the back. Just kind of go down a little bit. Take it down. That's the bacopa. Should be the bacopa back here. Give me an idea from the back of the tank looking to the front. You can see the swords. And sorry, I got my arm extended all the way in the back of the tank. But hope that comes out pretty cool. We'll see. And appreciate everybody watching, and need to go ahead and wrap this up. It's going to take forever to upload, but hope everybody has a great Sunday. And I'm going to stop this at the 20-minute mark, and it'll take a day to upload, I'm sure.